It's small, scruffy, but noisy. This tiny space is the self-declared People's Republic of Donetsk, where days ago it was just the local government building. It's a bit like the pro-Europe protests of Maidan Square in Kiev, the clumsy barricades, Molotov cocktails, tires ready to burn, and the lack of a leader or concrete plan, fed by local donations. But there's one huge difference. These people want to join Russia, and Russia, even its army, to help them do it. This man says he's from the Eastern Front, a new local group. We're about 6,000 people, he says, men ready to protect the fatherland, but women too, even the elderly.
Well, they say they've let us in because they want to show that they're here entirely peacefully, but there are clear preparations ready here. They're worried about an assault by Ukrainian forces, particularly from the roof. They barricaded the stairwells.
The power went out last night, many, like these nurses, fearing special forces were coming. But they didn't, and their numbers and readiness grow. Fears of poverty fuel this, that the rivalry between Kiev and Moscow will cost them their jobs, rising prices, wages worth less by the day. Some, like Tatiana, hanker for the Soviet past. My father was a retired KGB colonel, she says, and his genes must be passed on to me. This is why I'm here, and we're going to stand until the end. The top floor here was the new office of a Ukrainian billionaire, appointed governor by Kiev to fix the economy and to be rich beyond corruption. Sergei Tarhuta, elsewhere for now, says Moscow isn't behind this. It's mostly local complaints. We've had a lot of negotiations with them, he says. There are no people so committed here who'd be prepared to sacrifice their lives. This rhetoric borders on bravado, he says, adding the Russian forces on the border are aimed at imposing psychological pressure. This tiny pocket of grievances and whims sat at the heart of a massive struggle for Europe's East, and so powerful far beyond its size. Nick Payton-Walsh, CNN, Donetsk.